Hello guys, welcome and welcome back to my YouTube channel. So, kali ni Apis nak buat satu test, 7 hari test untuk Biore UV Barrier Me. This is a physical sunscreen yang Apis dapat bulan lepas, tapi Apis tak ada masa buat. Tapi kali ni kita akan buat eksperimen ni untuk 7 hari untuk this sunscreen, sebab this is the only one physical sunscreen that I have found dekat Watson. Kebanyakan dekat Watson ataupun Guardian, kita banyak jumpa yang chemical sunscreen. If you use a chemical sunscreen, dia memang meresap masuk dekat korang punya skin and dia tak really protect your skin very well. But this physical sunscreen, dia macam berfungsi seperti kaca yang akan pantulkan lagi cahaya daripada korang punya skin. Kalau korang nak tengok video yang Apis ada test this product, apa yang Apis first review this product, korang boleh tekan link dekat sini, okay? Jom kita try. Hari ini hari pertama Apis try this Biore UV Barrier Me. And dia mungkin agak ada white case sebab dalam ni ada zinc oxide dengan titanium dioxide. So mungkin korang akan nampak kelabu sikit bila korang pakai. Tapi it's okay, it's okay. This is just our base. And if siapa-siapa yang pakai makeup or anything else, okay, ini dia, tengok. Dia sangat-sangat ada white case. Bila korang pakai, mungkin muka korang agak kelabu. Dia ada white case. Oh my god, this is too much. Guys, this is so kelabu. I looks like Antu. So this is my day one after using this Biore UV Barrier Me. Today is day two. We are using this Biore UV Barrier Me sunscreen. Okay. Okay, this is the two after we applying that sunscreen. Korang boleh tengok, it's a lot of white case there. But it's okay. We will be protected today, whole day, okay guys? This is day two. Okay, sekarang ni Apis nak update. Apis baru pakai this sunscreen for macam berapa jam. And I don't like the texture of this sunscreen, you can see. Over here, the white case, dia macam bercapok. And I don't like that kind of the capok one on my skin. You see, there are a lot of capok sunscreen. So if korang start berpeluh, that white case akan transfer everywhere and dia akan macam berketul and bercepat-cepat at your face. So so far, I don't know if this is really sunscreen that I like, but yeah, maybe lain skin, lain dia punya effects. I don't know how to explain more. Tapi korang boleh tengok dia sangat-sangat bercapuk and I don't like it. So we will go to a next day, okay? Hari ni hari ketiga kita pakai this Biore UV Barrier Me. Okay, disebabkan semalam dia macam bercapuk, so hari ni aku explain nak pakai this Barrier Me Biore UV Barrier Me. Apis nak pakai dia dengan serum je. Apis akan letak serum and then Apis akan letak benda ni. You can see right now jerawat Apis dah kecut, dia dah rata. Kali ni Apis nak update. Ni Apis dah pakai dari pagi tadi, dari jam dalam jam 4 pagi sampai pukul 5 petang macam tu lah. Dia kena pukul 6. So far dia macam a bit bercapok and I don't like the texture of the sunscreen. tapi sebab dia ada top dengan cream, so that's why dia dia a bit macam boleh tahan. Kalau tak, kalau dia tak top dengan any cream, mungkin dia akan ada macam capuk dan tak sesuai on my skin. Korang boleh tengok kat sini ya. So far untuk 3 hari ni Apis tak sukalah dengan this sunscreen. Hello guys, hari ni Apis nak update my skin after 5 day Apis pakai that sunscreen. Okay, pada hari keempat hari tu my skin not totally okay sebab dia terlalu banyak white case. Tapi sekarang ni dia dah okay sikit lah. Mungkin Apis tak terlalu thick letak that sunscreen Biore UV Barrier Me. So korang boleh tengok my smile line. Dia ada still ada kesan macam white cast dekat sini, tapi still can acceptable lah. So so far so good after day 5 using this. But actually korang kena letak layer that sunscreen sangat-sangat thin lah, jangan terlalu thick sebab takut dia bila korang berpeluh dia boleh menyebabkan skin korang macam bercapuk again. And dia terlalu macam, yelah sebab dia terlalu thick, so bila korang berpeluh dia akan nampak white case tu macam pecah on your skin. So so far so good. Day 6 we are using this Biore UV Barrier Me. We just use a thin layer only, okay? No need to put much into our face. Okay, hari ni hari ke-6 finishing untuk this sunscreen. Ini Apis tak pakai. Sekarang ni dah jam 6 petang, so Apis nak update macam mana my skin bila pakai this sunscreen Biore UV Barrier Me. Korang boleh tengok dekat sini my skin a bit macam bercapuk bila close up dengan camera. This area Apis nampak dekat cermin dia bercapuk, tapi dekat kamera ni dia tak totally nampak. Mungkin sebab belum attach this footage dekat this video. So korang tengok dekat sini dia mungkin agak bercapuk and my skin look macam bumpy-bumpy. Maybe my skin also drying. Tapi right now my skin actually dia memang oily. So boleh tengok dekat sini dia macam bercapuk, tapi bila dari jauh macam ni dia finishing dia macam nice lah melalui kamera. Tapi kalau korang tengok through mirror dia sangat-sangat macam bercapuk, especially dekat my T-zone area, dekat bahagian hidung ini dia sangat-sangat bercapuk. Lagi-lagi habis pakai mask, habis boleh tunjuk this, korang boleh tengok still ada stain dekat my mask especially. Tapi kalau banyak macam ni still boleh terima lah. Kalau dia banyak Apis tak boleh terima. Sebab lagi pun that cream yang I use, foundation yang I use memang sangat-sangat full coverage. So that's why dia punya stain dekat that mask sangat-sangat sikit. Tapi still acceptable lah, memang normal. Kalau kita pakai mask dia still boleh lekat-lekat. Kita tak boleh nak expect dia betul-betul tak lekat dekat our mask. So so far I don't know, macam Apis, even nipis macam ni pun still nampak macam fake sebab dia memang pecah hari ni. So I don't know. Okay, hari ni hari 6 Apis update this sunscreen. Hello guys, today is day 7, hari ke-7 after we are using this Barrier Me Biore UV Barrier Me sunscreen. Korang boleh tengok dia memang still tetap bercapuk bila dah petang. Apis pakai ni dari jam 4 pagi tadi sampai pukul 6 petang. So korang boleh tengok dia memang bercapuk. And then korang boleh tengok white cast yang ada dekat my skin disebabkan oleh that sunscreen sangat obvious. Korang boleh tengok. So Apis tak sure this sesuai dengan korang punya skin, tapi as my opinion lah, Apis tak berminat dengan this sunscreen. Tapi yang best, korang boleh tengok dekat sini, slowly my acne, dia jadi macam acne scar only. Jerawat totally macam mengecut and sangat-sangat best lah. And then the best part, korang punya cream tahan, cuma dia bercapuk. And then tengok ni, korang boleh tengok, dia bercapuk cuma dia tak oily. Itu je yang best tentang this sunscreen, dia tak oily bila korang pakai. And then korang punya skin still macam stay on point lah, boleh tahan jugalah. So far Apis tak recommend sebab lagipun dalam produk ni ada fragrance, and mungkin siapa-siapa yang ada sensitive skin boleh menyebabkan skin korang irritate. And mungkin korang boleh beli ada sunscreen yang tak ada macam bahan-bahan yang menyebabkan skin korang sensitive, yang menyebabkan skin korang sensitive. So good luck for finding your good sunscreen, and thank you for watching me guys. Bye, don't forget to like and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Bye guys.